A huge spoiler warning if you couldn't tell already. So, Squid Game, the show that has taken the world by storm. Now, if you haven't seen Squid Game yet, you're probably living on a different planet. The show that is currently rated number one in the United States. Now, you probably saw the title and was like, well, did you even watch the show first? How can you judge it if you haven't watched it?
I'd just like to let you know that I watched the entire show in one day.
And the reason for that is because I saw a bunch of Instagram posts, and I couldn't fucking escape it. No matter where I turned, I saw Squid Game. It was almost as if it was fucking haunting me. And even fucking LeBron James watches it.
Yep, I did finish. Did you finish it? You watched it?
Yes.
You done?
Yes. I guess if you were emailing me about the whole shit.
Yeah, I didn't like the ending. No, I know they started off with a season two, but like, get on the fucking flight, go see the dog, bro. Like, what are you doing?
Oh my god, we were just talking about that.
People literally just made that point.
Oh,
it's so great.
It's 5 billion, bro. You gonna beat no dog, bro? What the fuck?
Yes, LeBron, we agree with you. Because everybody knows that fucking Ki-hoon or whatever the fuck his name is should have just got on the flight and fucking ignored it. And let's be honest here, what is he gonna fucking do with one person? All other 455 people that did the game are dead. He has no allies. What the fuck is Ki-hoon gonna do? Turn into fucking John Wick? Is he gonna infiltrate the base and start killing everybody? Even the detective couldn't fucking do that. Speaking of the detective, why the fuck would he die? Now, we all know that this game has been running on for years, apparently, and nobody has fucking even got close to cracking down on who's behind it all. I'm not saying that we don't know. Obviously, we fucking know. It's a fucking old man with fucking dementia. But no other person knows who it is. And also, Ollie didn't deserve to die like that. Sungwoo is currently in the gulag, which I can absolutely respect that. But why would Ollie, out of all characters, the one Indian dude, why the Indian dude have to die? I'm not making any accusations, but like, that's kind of rape. And why the other fucking girl have to die like that? I forgot her name, but I'll throw her fucking picture up. She died to a shard of glass. And then, as soon as Ki-hoon runs off, this snake that Sungwoo is slides in and cuts her throat. That is some bullshit. I mean, she already would have died in the first place with a shard of glass, but she shouldn't have died in that way in the first place. They all beat the level, and they all passed, so why the fuck would they shatter all the glass, even though they know that one of them is gonna die eventually if they get too close to the fucking glass? And also, what about the VIPs? They had no character development. There's just one episode where all the VIPs, no names whatsoever. We only see one face of the fucking VIPs, and he looks like a fucking Redditor. He looks like he moderates Discord servers, to be honest. He's at least talked to 20 miners in his lifetime. The VIPs just arrive out of nowhere with fucking golden mask on, and they're just some random Americans. In which, it was a good idea to make them American, just to show that this is way bigger than just Korea. But they just arrived and started watching, except for the other fat white dude. And also, a lot of the plot twists were kinda, you know, recognizable and very predictable. I think we all knew that the front man was gonna be the detective's brother. It wasn't really that crazy. So yes, I do think this show is heavily overrated. I think one of the main reasons why it's so big is because that's the popular opinion, that it's not overrated and it's really good. Don't get me wrong, this could be show of the year. It could be. But I mean, it's very, very overrated. And the reason why is because there's so many little details that are absolutely horrible. And I mean, they've chosen some actual, like, horrible actors for the show. Especially for the VIPs. When they talk, it's not really believable. And it's a very generic, rich person betting on other people's lives type of thing. Same thing could be said for commentary, but that's a whole different thing. In conclusion, Squid Game copied Total Drama Island. No, I ain't too proud.